can report from a cell phone these days and then send it right back to the newsroom using a Wi-Fi connection or any local type of internet connection. And that's really what we want to instill in our students, is that when you see news right on the spot, you do have the ability to capture it and send it back someplace and get paid for it. Journalism is serious. It's hard. It's not something that you're just going to succeed at very quickly. Good, with steady. She's right in the middle. The way that you sound has to kind of translate to different places. Let's do that again. Don't try to hide it. Let me see. That's really what the Mojo Project is. It's giving them these new mobile skills and also teaching them how to be entrepreneurial in the process of gathering and reporting news.
People want food that tastes delicious. And I don't care how sustainable, how healthful food is. If it isn't tasty, I don't want it.
I'm Brian Terry, and I'm a chef, a food justice activist, and an author of 3 cookbooks.
I actually started off as a grassroots activist working in New York City with young people. I was deeply concerned that many communities simply didn't have access to healthy, affordable, fresh food. So I wanted to really help them think about what they were eating, where their food came from, how it was affecting their personal health and well-being. And in the beginning, there were days when I was going out and doing these workshops and they said that they don't want to hear about, you know, food that they don't like. But I think the thing that kept me going is this sense of urgency. It's really a personal mission. It's really about me wanting to prolong the life of the people that I care about.
I'm a chef, I'm a nutritionist, I'm a TV host, and a professional eater. I started cooking with my grandmother. That's where I really learned to cook. Whatever my grandmother was doing, that's what I did.
Like Doc McStuffins, because when I was a little girl, I wanted to be a doctor too.
She's an emergency doctor. When there's a really big ouchie, she's the one who makes you feel all better.
Sometimes big boo-boos need to be treated right away.
We've got an emergency, everyone. Oh my!
When children come to the emergency room, I try to make them feel more comfortable by talking to them so they understand everything that's going on.
We're talking about the need for more black men to step up and teach with Amari Todd, an educator and senior vice president of the regional operations team of Teach for America.
Well, in Teach for America, what we're doing is we're recruiting on the top 450 college campuses throughout the country. We're prioritizing 35 of the historically black colleges and universities. And this year, 5% of the applicants to Teach for America identified as black men. And that's compared to 2% of the national average of the number of black men in education. While I don't think we figured it out, I think we're on the right track and there's still more work to do, and we're committed to doing that.
Pastor said, what we need now is a new normal. You nodded your head. Tell me what you think that means.
Yeah, that was my good friend, Reverend Tracy Blackman. What she suggested was that the way we've been doing business, particularly, and I think she specified in the St. Louis region, the way we've been doing business is not acceptable.
My name is Terrence Osborne. I'm from New Orleans, and I'm a visual artist. I love color. I love to paint. I always had a passion for art. It's that love and that passion for doing your craft that you cannot stay away from. You know, you don't have a choice. It's driven by something that is much greater than me. Through my art, I'm able to express myself. I don't think there's anything else that gets close to that other than my art.